All right, so first let me start by saying peace to the gods and goddesses of Planet Kai. Peace meaning positive energy always creates elevation. Peace to the ancestors for blessing us, working through us, and, you know, standing behind us and coming back to help us during this time. It's definitely needed. I want to send peace to the youth, the hood, the people that tune in on this university from the streets that's trying to find themselves. Welcome to the university. I want you to know that you're in good hands with me. I break shit down the way it needs to get broken down for you, okay? All right, but I want to talk about soul harvesting a little bit again. If a lot of y'all seen my first video on soul harvesting, on the truth about the moon, this will be a part two to that first video. All right, and I feel like it's needed because I wanted to point something out. Now, notice how when I started this video, I started it with that prayer. And that prayer is a prayer that was always said for years and years and years and years and years. And we never thought about that prayer. We never knew that prayer had a deeper meaning to it. When I speak to you, I've been teaching you all about witchcraft and the way that it works. You get what I'm saying? The way witchcraft works. And spell casting spells with the words that we say out of our mouth. So that prayer, that ancient prayer, now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my keep. And the one we know is, now I lay me down to sleep. I pray the Lord my, if I should die before I wake, I pray the Lord my to take. That's the one we know, the shorter version. But the one I put at the beginning of this video is the actual version, the English version. You get what I'm saying? So that prayer, it was, it's spell casting. And when you was taught to say that prayer, you literally casted your soul to the moon. When you, that prayer is a prayer that binds your soul back to the moon. That's how deep it get. We never knew that, but this is the actual fact. That prayer, when they taught you to get on your knees, close your eyes, because they make you pray with both of your hands facing each other. They make your palms face inward when you pray because they want you to close your eyes. These are your gateways. These help open portals. So now you're on your knees praying with your gateways closed, and you're speaking these words either mentally or verbally. So you're binding your soul to their man-made holograph moon when you did that. Okay, now those words, especially, now imagine a person that's religious and they've been saying that prayer their whole life. It's repetition. So you're casting that spell over yourself, saying it over and over and over and over and over again your entire life. All right, you saying this spell that you think is a prayer. And then at the moment you leave this realm where your soul is transcending the atmosphere, like they showed you in the movie, Soul. And like I've been told y'all before, Soul came out on my first video, part one to this. And I'll leave it in the description, though, of this video, part one, a link to it. If you want to see it again, I recommend you go watch it. And then I recommend you go watch the movie Soul, just to get a deeper understanding of the soul and the spirit. Because in this university, you need to grasp that fundamental understanding of that before grabbing other lessons that I'm going to be pushing moving forward, of the soul, the spirit, and what we are, and how this physical avatar is just technology. All right? This is technology. This is just technology. All right? So, our oppressors, they're very tricky. You know, understanding that we come from the Sirius star system, you know, and we travel here as souls, our real bodies back home on the Sirius star system. So imagine watching the movie Soul, how they showed you the portal being opened. And then when they showed you the portal being open, and she offered for him to give him a second chance to go back to Earth, how that portal was just open. That's literally how it is in the astral realms. It works exactly like that. Okay, so we all came through these portals and elected to come down here. But majority of us, when it's time for us to leave, you're not supposed to stay. Your soul's supposed to keep going. But what they do is, they have that moonlight there. And that's what they're showing you in the movie Soul. This moonlight that's sitting right outside the atmosphere, because it takes the soul 40 to 72 days to fully transcend the atmosphere once it leaves the body. You know, so your soul retains its memories. Nothing else is real. But you do take your memories with you. So when you etch that witchcraft into your soul remembers it. So that's why when you're transcending the atmosphere and you see that light, it's so easy for many souls to go back into that, like having went through the soul bleaching program here on this realm, because they bleach your soul twice. When you at the moment they call death and your soul is transcending this atmosphere, they capture it with the moon's light, bring it in, and they bleach your soul of its memories. All right, once they bleach the soul of its memories, they open up portal, shoot it right back to this atmosphere. Once the soul come back to this atmosphere, you can come back as many things. You can come back to a body, a cat, objects, like a bottle of water. You get what I'm saying? Honestly, you can. Because it's just energy. You know, it's just energy. And they kind of showed you all this in the movie Soul. And if you haven't seen it, then spoiler alert, because I'm definitely probably fucking it up for you. But I really don't give a fuck, because I'm using this as a for lecture purposes right now. Okay? But yeah, that's actually what happened. All right? So us being gods and goddesses, that's where that term comes from, because we are the soul, the spirit. We are not the body. All right? And we come from these different star systems through portals here. And instead of them teaching you that you're coming here through a portal, they teach you that you're being born. Instead of teaching you that when you go to sleep, you're really not sleep. You're going to different portals and entering different avatars and different bodies that you have, they teach you that you sleep. Instead of teaching you that your soul never dies, they teach you death. And the only reason they teach you death is because they created time, and they filled our atmosphere with oxygen. So making us breathe oxygen is the reason why the body begins to age. You get what I'm saying? So, and then they also taught you time. So it's two factors impacting you that make the avatar age and make you believe in death, and then thus it is. All right? But naturally it wasn't like that, you know. And this is all technology that's being cast over us by our oppressors, which is the human beings, the hierarchy human beings, and the draconian reptilians. You know, all your world powers. Okay? So understand why that moon technology that they created was powerful. It was big because they know that we come here through portals. So they completely hijacked the realm by shutting down the portals. You know, by them causing other souls to reincarnate and come back here, that put them in a position to control who's actually here. You get what I'm saying? Many new souls can't come in if you steady recycling the same souls. You get what I'm saying? It's supposed to be your soul come here, you keep flowing and going, they shut all that down. With the moon. The moon caused reincarnation. All right. So you have elected souls like myself and some and others that choose to come back. They already broke free of that cycle, but they really came back for a purpose. So understand the science of what's been going on in this realm. This is why you should not fear death, because it's not real. They have been using the fear of death to stop those that are here, the souls that are here, from rising within this realm to help free this realm for those on the outside can come in and fully we can take over the realm. You know, us, the ancestors. So it gets deep, but it's technology and all is being revealed, because everything without a soul is about to be eradicated by the planet, by us, nature. We are nature. So what's happening right now is all these lies are being torn down so that we can see again. So that we can see again. For us to see clearly again, we have to tear the lies down. All right. So understand that witchcraft is real. Magic is real. And one of the biggest spells we was spoke ever was that prayer. Even if you didn't speak it, it was spoken religion. It was spoken by family members. It was played around you. You know it, right? Right. So that means your soul recognizes it. Your soul shouldn't even know those words, but yet it does. Right? And this witchcraft, this spell, you speak over yourself. So you cast your soul back into the moonlight when you transcend the atmosphere, because you have been speaking this frequency your entire life. All right, but I don't want to make this video too long with the touch on soul harvesting. Again, this is a perfect time for that, because when we're talking about us being gods and goddesses, understand what makes you that. All right, understand that you are the soul traveling in the body, experiencing this realm, but you experience other realms. You are a multidimensional being. All right, Peace to the gods and the goddesses of Planet Kai. I came in perfect peace. I leave as I come.